Sam Stone calls Steve Austin like a damn dog. What are your thoughts on this whole heinous man?
I really don't know what to think about that, Jr. I don't know what's more confusing, whether it's the fact that he said that he ran over Stone Cold Steve Austin, or whether it's the fact that we know he actually did run over Stone Cold, or it's the fact that he said he did it for me.
What about that? What about the fact that Rikishi says, I did this in the name of The Rock. I did this all for The Rock. How does that make you feel? What are your thoughts on that?
How do you think it makes me feel? Makes me feel sick to my stomach to think that, you know, with everything I've accomplished here in the WWF, and before Survivor Series, before Steve got ran over, I was already multi-time WWF champion, as you know. So, you know, for him to say that he did it for me, for him to say that he did it for me so I could rise to the top of the WWF, almost, you know, insinuating or actually telling me and telling the fans out there, negating everything that The Rock has already done, like I couldn't have done it on my own, is sickening to my stomach. I don't know what to think when I hear something like that. And then for him to say that he did it for me and for me to be in the same ring with him, and I looked this man in the eyes, and here's a guy who I knew my whole life, or I thought I knew my whole life for that matter, and I looked him in the eyes and he's telling me that he did it for me, and I sincerely believe that he actually believes that he did the right thing, which scares the hell out of me.
What do you think about the fact that Rikishi said that the WWF is all about the Great White Hope?
That's a bunch of to me, Jr. For him to sit there and say something like that, for him to bring up all these other guys, all these great champions of the WWF, Bob Backlund and Stone Cold Steve Austin and Bruno Sammartino, and to say that our people have been held back. You know, I mean, I was given the same opportunity as everybody else in my family was, from my grandfather and my dad, and we all took advantage of it as far as I'm concerned. For him to throw the race card in there is just... it's ridiculous. And anybody that knows me knows that that's my biggest turnoff. It's my biggest pet peeve for somebody to say something like that. But, you know, again, I go back to the fact, Jr., that I was in the ring with him. We were all in the same arena that night, but I was in the ring with Rikishi. I was in there. Mick Foley was in there. And I looked at him, and he honestly believes that he did the right thing by running over Steve. He honestly believes that he did the right thing for me, for that matter. And what me off is a simple fact that he says, that he casts a doubt in some people's minds out there that, well, maybe The Rock couldn't have done it. Well, the fact of the matter is, he didn't cast a doubt in my mind. You know, I could have done everything I've done here in the WWF with Steve Austin standing right by my side, or right in front of my face, for that matter. Either way.
Stone Cold is expected here tonight. What are you going to say to him when you see him?
I've already talked to Steve. I talked to him Monday night. We're on the phone for an hour. I talked to him this afternoon. I've been talking to him throughout his whole rehab, so I hate like hell that it even happened to him, and I was happy as hell the fact that he came back. You know, I talked to him already, and he knows that I didn't have anything to do with it. And he's cool with that, but what he's not cool with, obviously, is Rikishi.
And do you have a problem with that, as far as Stone Cold having this intense rage at Rikishi?
Well, why would I have a problem with that? Why would I have a problem with Stone Cold wanting to beat the living out of Rikishi tonight? Quite frankly, he should. And I'm torn. I'm torn between kind of emotions because I've known Rikishi my whole life, and I've never known him to do anything like that. But seeing as he did do it, well, he deserves what's coming to him. So, no, I have no problem. I have no problem with how Stone Cold feels.
Rock, given the kind of temperament that Austin has today, what kind of advice would you give him?
Well, I'm not here to give Stone Cold advice. That's just not The Rock's way. The Rock doesn't give Stone Cold advice. Stone Cold doesn't give The Rock advice. But I will say this. You know, you and I both know Stone Cold very, very well. And I just hope that Steve Austin doesn't do anything to Rikishi that Austin's going to regret for the rest of his life.
Well, King, some stirring words by The Rock there. Obviously affected by this. At one point, he said he was sick to his stomach over it.
Well, he also said he hopes that Stone Cold doesn't do anything he'll regret for the rest of his life. If Stone Cold runs over Rikishi when he gets here, Stone Cold will regret that for the rest of his life. He could wind up in jail. Now, the other thing that bothers me is the fact that The Rock said he could have done everything he did with Stone Cold standing right here. But if you ask me, there's only room for one at the top, not two. What would have really happened had they both been here at the same time?
Well, they're both here now, King, at the same time, and we're going to find out. Meanwhile, we are getting set for a big tag team matchup. Y2J, Chris Jericho, and Billy Gunn to take on X-Pac and Eddie Guerrero.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a battle, King, tonight on SmackDown. And there you see X-Pac,
the heated rivalry with Y2J. Revenge on his mind for Billy Gunn, who cost X-Pac two big matches last week. And there he is.
Billy Gunn, look out! There's Eddie Guerrero!
Eddie Guerrero, a sneak attack! Attacking Billy Gunn from behind!
This is not the first time! He did it Monday night on Raw, except he used a beer bottle!
Well, oh, now what's he got?
It was... You want to
look at this! Oh! What a shot to the back of Billy Gunn! Eddie Guerrero has taken out Billy Gunn!
We're back on SmackDown, and King, during the break, EMTs tending to Billy Gunn, the victim of that vicious assault from behind by Eddie Guerrero.
Well, he was hit by what looked like a tire iron or something right in that shoulder. That
he may have a concussion. Maybe out. But he has a broken arm.
Take care of it.
That's Commissioner Foley on hand, King.
Let's go.
Okay. He's got that weapon. It is definitely a tire iron.
Well, that's what happens when you mess with a member. You want something? Man, you want to get it by
hand? You watch your step, Eddie. You watch your step. Hey, first you screw things up with China. Now you're going to take Billy Gunn out. I'll tell you what, you're not off the hook. It's no longer a tag team match. What I'm talking about is you running back, getting your Intercontinental belt, because it's on the line now. No. It's a triple threat match. You, the champion.
All right, come on, man.
Chris Jericho and X-Pac, and it's coming up now.
Whoa.
Get out of here.
Did you hear that, Michael?
Yeah, Commissioner Mick Foley laying down the law.
Good.
It's good. It's about time.